Yeah, I'm not surprised this is leaking. This is totally rusted. So the easiest way to get to this radiator is to take the fan and the fan shroud off. So I'm going to do that. It's held in by four bolts and two down on the bottom. Mine are 13 millimeter. Once you get the four bolts out, and I can tell you, I had to get this AC condenser out of the way. I just bungee corded, put it up on the place on the hood, but you got to get that out of the way. And then the two bottom bolts, the one on the driver's side over here is down below that brace right there. Right there. It's you got to fish. I had to fish a swivel in there, and I also needed an extension on the passenger side. You'll need a deep well, 13 millimeter deep well, and you'll need a shallow 13 millimeter. You need to take this brace off that holds the condenser in. That's one 10 millimeter bolt right there. Once you get it out, you can just unplug it then. In order to get the shroud off, you got to get this because of this right here. It will not come over. This is just a cutout in the shroud. So you have to get this off. That's a 13 millimeter. I just use these flare wrench. Keep from stripping it out. Because if you strip that out, you get yourself some trouble for sure. Once you get the transmission cooler line out of the way, it'll come right out. The shroud comes right off. But I figured this is the easiest way to explain this is you've got a series of, I used a 19/32 inch socket, quarter inch drive. You've got to take a series of, there are two on the sides. This is the shroud. Two on the sides over here, one on this side and one on the other. Two, three, four, five. You've got to get those out. Again, I used the 19/32, and you've got a series of 10 millimeter bolts that have to be removed. Here's one, here's two, three, four, five, six, seven. Probably 14, there would be 7 on each side. Anyway, those have to come out. Yeah, this definitely, this radiator is probably the original, because it has definitely got some trouble. I'm not surprised it was leaking. I'm going to turn the camera off and keep moving on, get the rest of it out of here. Hey, once you get all the hoses off and you get the transmission cooler lines out, I'll give you a heads up. Be careful about the cooler line on the bottom, the transmission cooler on the bottom. Mine was rusted. Like, if you look at most of the radiators, is rusted. That bottom cooler line was pretty rusted, and I used these flare nuts to get it off. Sprayed it down with PV Blaster before I even started working on it. I tightened it, moved it back and forth, tightening and loosening until it finally came off. But once I was able to get the bottom transmission cooler line free, the flare nut right there, the flare nut was actually rusted onto the tube, so I had to take a flare nut wrench and some PB Blaster, work that flare nut loose until I could spin it with my fingers. So I've got it freed up really nice now. You don't want to force this flare nut into the new aluminum radiator with a wrench. You just want to be able to kind of finger tighten it up in there and get it started really nicely. So I ended up having to put some PB Blaster. It was frozen to the tube. It was rusted frozen to the tube. That'll just rinse the tube and pinch it. So got to be careful with that bottom transmission cooler line. I can't really get the camera down in there very good to show you, but there's a cutout right there. There's a cutout right there's a cutout on the bottom shroud support right there where the transmission cooler line goes into the radiator. This bolt, this radiator nut right there gets caught on that. You can easily take the left side of the driver's side and lift it right up and it'll come right up. That gets hung up on this, on that cutout on the bottom radiator support shroud. So you gotta kinda take a screwdriver. I had to take a screwdriver down and pry it back a little bit in order to get it to clear that, and then the radiator just comes right out. But yeah, that's where I'm at right now. Once you get all your hoses disconnected, get all these lines loose, radiator comes right out. Okay, I ended up having to shave some of the rubber off the rubber support boots that sit down on the bottom of the radiator support bracket on the bottom, so the new radiator would fit in there, because it's a little wider. The aftermarket radiators are a little wider than the original stock, and I couldn't find one that was would fit, so I just shaved a little bit of rubber off of it to get it to set down in there. Well, right now I've done a dry fit, and all the hoses and everything line up really nice. All the transmission cooler lines, the AC condenser lines all go in. So haven't got the top shroud, the top brace on there yet, but so far so good. But yeah, you're gonna have to trim your rubber boots that the radiator sits down in back a little bit, because this radiator is a little wider than the original. But I'll give you a friendly heads up on these AC condenser lines, cooling lines. They all go on very easily with just your finger. And I would finger tighten all the transmission cooler lines in there and get them started really easy with your finger, because if you strip those out, then you've got a really big problem. So far so good. But today I'm going to take a break. One of the hardest things to do on this job is getting this upper radiator and condenser saddle lined back up with all these bolt holes. But because you've got like two, you see you've got two rubber nipples on the, you have these rubber saddles that fit on the bottom. They fit the radiator and the condenser. The condenser sits in here right here. The radiator sits in here. You have them on the bottom. And you also have them on the top underneath the shroud right here. Trying to get those lined back up with a new radiator that's an aftermarket radiator was a knuckle buster. But eventually I got it done. Just a heads up. And you have to do a lot of trimming to get this new cap and the radiator inside of this shroud. You have to do a little trimming. I just used a razor blade, trimmed it out. Most of these aftermarket radiators for an 84 Corvette come with this half inch nipple on it for the oil cooler line, but because these radiators fit 84 up to 89, I think, most of these aftermarket. It's very difficult to find an 84 radiator for just an 84. So that oil cooler line right there has to be capped off. I'm going to put one of these HPS caps. It's for high heat. And I just don't want to fool with it again, but it's a half inch. Just slides right on there. And then of course you would need a cap. I mean, you'd need a hose clamp on it. It is working. Everything's working. It is a bear to get in there though. The aftermarket radiators for the 84 do not fit perfectly, but it works. It looks nice. And it's running cool, so.